So Boy Scout is a concept typically in the US where young students, it's something somewhat like an NCC. So one day, this Boy Scout went home to his mom and said, "Mama, me and five of my friends today helped an old woman to cross the road." So Mama said, "Johnny, that's very good. I'm proud of you. But tell me, why do you need five of you to cross, help one old woman to cross?" And Johnny said, "Mama, she didn't want to cross."
Okay.
So, any or every human need gives and provides you with an opportunity for kindness. Need. Now, unlike Johnny, we don't have to create a need. When there is a need, there is an opportunity for kindness. A kindness without a perceived or actual need can result in something else. So, there was this guy, Michael Daub. Michael Daub was a student in a US university. He was an art student, much like a Mahavir Jain. He was into sculpting. So like many Westerners, you know, young Westerners, he came to India in search of spirituality. And as he was walking, wearing baggy jeans and a scraggy beard, he was walking down the streets of Calcutta, two little beggars, took him or helped him to get in touch with a tiny man. It was a kindness on his part that he was kind to them and they led him to this tiny nun. And this nun told him to take care of the dying and about to die people in a temple in Calcutta. As he took care of them for a month, there was a whole new involvement, so to say, to him. These dying people were at one time in good positions. Some were teachers, some were government servants, but now they were poor. For a month or so, he helped them out, and then as his money ran out, he went back to the US. They say, you can take a man out of India, but you cannot take India out of a man. Well, this man went to US and he pursued his career in sculpting. And after a few years, he saved enough. And one day, he took a flight and landed at the feet of this nun. This nun was, any guesses?
Mother Teresa.
She told him, "See, all you young people all want to live in the cities. The need is in the villages." So he again packed his bag. And 10 and a half hour journey in a train reached Juanga in Orissa, a poor, destitute village in Orissa. There, under a tree where all the villagers gathered, he asked, through an interpreter of course, "What do you need?" And they said, "We need doctors. We need medicines. We need pharmacies." So he collected some money, collected donations, and built a 30-bed hospital in Juanga. Within a month, over 1,000 patients were treated, and some of these patients had never seen a doctor in their life. You could say a random act of kindness. It was kindness to those two children which brought him here. And he is a happy man. He still lives in India. And he has not restricted himself to the hospital alone. He has opened schools in Orissa, in Juanga. Kindness. Now, Michael Daub was, shall we call it, an exemplary example of a kind-hearted man. We don't have to go to so much such lengths to be kind. We can be kind in our own way. Honestly, if you ask me, I'm not a very kind person. Seriously. 9 times out of 10, when I stop in a traffic signal, I put the car windows up. Because I don't want to be hassled by those beggars. I don't want to anyway get, okay, once in a odd time I do part with my money. But the irony is, I realized it, it's not always that they are looking for money. Sometimes they just need a little acknowledgement. Once it so happened, one of those transvestites came knocking on the door of my car door, and I thought, okay, let me give something. And then I pulled out my purse, everything, but I was not getting that change. And I put my hands up and just gave a smile, a sad smile. That fellow gave me such a wonderful smile, it made my day. So that kindness also we do not allow ourselves to share with others. Take for instance, how many of us today, how many of you sitting here today have acknowledged the presence of the person sitting next to you? No, don't worry, I'm not going to ask you to look into the other person's eyes and shake hands and all. No. Just have you acknowledged the person next to you? That is an act of kindness. How many of us say good morning to somebody unknown? Only we wait for the other person, okay, he's going to say, then we... For that matter, there are some of us, some of our friends on Facebook, who keep on uploading photos. Sometimes I feel they are really lonely. There's no harm in just going ahead and putting a like or saying a good word to them. All acts of kindness. And it all comes back to you someday. Today, to take the meeting forward, we have a wonderful person, a jolly good fellow, a student who enjoys theater, who is a skater. We came to know that last week only. And now he is serving as a office bearer within six months of his joining the Toastmasters movement. A true artist and a, what shall we call it, sportsman. Let's put our hands together to welcome Mahavir Jain.